So what we're going to deal with is Martin Eve. You hate the good and love evil. Who said that? The prophet Micah said that. Someone get that. Someone go to the book of Micah, the third chapter, and read verse 1. And this is the Martin Eve, huh? Martin Eve hate good. I tell you this, man. Eve, she could be in a nice home, marry, have children, not want for nothing, but Eve is so wicked and stupid. She doesn't focus on all the positive things that the Most High has blessed her with in her life. She'll find one negative thing. And since Eve is an emotional creature, she was made emotional. She allowed her emotions to provoke her to focus on that one negative thing, and it destroys everything that she has. Then she spends the remainder of her life miserable or trying to get it back. But often she doesn't. So that's what we're talking about here. You love the evil. Or should I say you hate the good and you love the evil. That's what the prophet Micah say. Someone got that?
Facts.
Micah, the third chapter.
Book of Micah, chapter 3, verse 1. And I said, "Hear, I pray you, O heads of Jacob, and ye princes of the house of Israel, is it not for you to know judgment?"
Okay, so he's talking to the leaders. See, this is a problem when the leaders don't do right. And that's what it is in this society. The leaders won't do right. They know Eve is off. They know Eve is wicked. They try to justify. I'm going to hit you something, man. A man could go to one of these jacked up pastors or this Masonic court system, and he'll get ridiculed. Instead of them hearing what the man is saying, they would say, "What is it that you're doing that's pissing your wife off and cause her to behave like that?" You know what I'm talking about? They won't put any blame on her, huh? It's always someone else's fault why she's acting like she's acting. So the leaders, what Micah is saying, listen, man, aren't you responsible for justice? See what it is, man. These leaders are more concerned about what's fair versus justice. See, what's fair, the Most High don't deal with what's fair, man. The Most High deal with justice. Man deals with what's fair. Well, it's not fair that you rule over your woman. I don't give a damn what you think is fair, man. We're going to do thus saith Yahuwah.
So fair.
They said it's not fair if you are a misogynist. Well, you might want to call the Most High that, because he set up that order. He set up that divine order. See, he doesn't deal with what's fair. He deals with just. What's just? And since he's the creator, if he say a thing, that's what we're supposed to do. Now, you can like that, understand it, believe it or not. And then most of these Eves are wicked, man. They don't do just. They want what's fair. Because they're of the world. And I fast and I pray when the Most High bring about this destruction, man. Because most of you Eves are going down. Your spirits are off. Your spirits are off. You shouldn't even be touching the Bible. A demon shouldn't touch the Bible, man. A demon shouldn't touch that Bible, man. That's a fact, man. Go ahead, read up.
Verse 2. Who hate the good.
Yeah, they hate the good. God.
And love the evil.
What's the good? The scriptures say, he that knoweth to do good and doeth it not is sin. What is good? It means keeping the law. So she hate the good. What is the good that she hate? Genesis 3 and 16. What is the good that she hate? Ephesians 5, 22 to 24. What is the good that she hate? 1 Corinthians 11, 1, 2, 3. What is the good that she hates? Titus 2, verse 5. It goes on and on and on. That's the good that she hates. The Most High gonna judge you for that. Many of you are suffering right now, man. Read on up.
Who pluck off their skin from off them and their flesh from off their bones.
See that? See that? So as I give this message, man, through the spirit of the Ruach HaKadosh, right? It's exceedingly difficult for me to say these words that's going to follow, but it has to be hard, man. It has to be said. And you Eves need to hear it. I done a short earlier today. One sister said, I needed to hear this. It's very unlikely that a sister's going to say, yeah, I needed to hear this. Because I was telling them, a woman could have everything that the other women out there want, right? See, they get stupid and complacent and comfortable when they're with a man that's giving them the things that they thought they want. But Satan got a hold of them. So she forgets all the things that she have and concentrate on the negative thing that she want because of desire. Why? Because she hate the good and she love the evil. And so what Micah is talking about here, he's talking about leaders that don't check these Eves, that don't check people. See, a leader, well, let me tell you something. When a man sin is bad, right? But when a leader, someone that call themselves a pastor, a preacher, somebody, shout out to JD for the donation. Somebody that set themselves up as a rabbi or a leader of a church. When you allow wrong to go forth, you're doing a devil evil. That's a devil evil. And I'm going to hit you with something, man. There's hundreds of pastors who won't do right. And that's what I'm talking about here tonight. Preachers, pastors, rabbis, Israelite camps. They are men, many of them, of impeccable justice. I've had a privilege of interacting with a lot of so-called leaders, sit in court, watch how they do, how they railroad men. Men get divorce rate. No Vaseline. They bend him over. He come out of the court with more than half of his substance gone. Straight divorce rate. Talk to another Eve, tell her about it. She try and justify it. Because why? She got demons on her. A lot of these people are crafty enchanters, skillfully. They shepherd the people, but in the wrong way. See, it's a privilege to minister Yahuwah's word to the saints who are in the church with these brothers and sisters in Yahusha. So consequently, any of you under the sounds of my voice, any of you pastors, any of you listening to this, right? Any of you that set yourselves up as leaders, any of you in the court system, right? The words you're about to hear is about to bother you. Because sadly enough, not all these rabbis, these pastors, these preachers, these priests are shepherds of Yahuwah. They're not doing right by Yahuwah's flock. They're not doing acts of justice. See, sometimes injustice is difficult to define. We might know it when we see it or experience it. But how do you articulate it? How do you articulate injustice in everyday terms? How do you do that? How do you do that? How exactly can you tell when a leader is practicing injustice? How you all think? How can you determine that? How should we define injustice?